Hey guys, so as most of you already know, we are seeing this seismic shift within the music licensing industry towards subscription-based platforms. And so I guess a little bit more than 4 months ago now, I decided to get on board and apply to be an author on Motion Array. And this was based on some of the recommendations that I'd heard from Daniel Carrizales from Stock Music Licensing. I know that many of my subscribers are following him, but if you don't, then please go check out his channel. It's a wealth of information about music libraries, and he's just an all-around awesome dude. So yeah, go check him out, and thank you very much, Daniel, for recommending Motion Array to me. So I want to chat a little bit about my experience with Motion Array, and I want to let you guys know what I've made there in the last month. But before I do, I'd just like to mention very quickly that if you're looking for feedback on your music, then please feel free to join my Discord community. There's a growing list of like-minded composers there that would be more than happy to share their opinions and thoughts with you on your music. And also, you can find me on Patreon, and I'd be happy to give you more direct and thorough feedback on your music, as well as you'll have access to sample packs, MIDI packs, full composing, mixing and mastering videos, and more. So check it out, links below. Okay, so let's chat about Motion Array. For those of you who are unfamiliar with this library, I should mention right off the bat that you do need to apply to be an author. So reading through some of the comments on Daniel's videos about Motion Array, I can see that there was a lot of people who applied and were turned down, which is understandably really, really frustrating. But you know, I think the truth is that there's no two libraries that are the same, and just because your music isn't a great match for one library doesn't mean that you're not gonna find success on another one, and that is certainly the case for me. But I also think that it's worth mentioning that before you do apply for any library for that matter, it's really, really important to have a solid understanding of what kind of music is selling on that platform. Now, with many libraries, you actually don't even have the option of filtering the search results based on sales or popularity, but with Motion Array, you do. So that was the first thing that I looked at before I applied. And to be clear, I made sure to filter the search results based on most popular in the last month. Not most popular of all time, because you get two completely different results in those respective categories. In fact, it's actually really interesting to see the difference between the two, because if we take a quick look at all-time bestsellers, you'll see that the tracks actually date back to a time before they changed the rules about naming your tracks descriptively, which is something that they don't allow anymore. So what I mean is, like, you have to name your songs creatively. So like, instead of something like corporate uplifting inspirational, you have to call it something like, Beautiful New Day. So I think personally that's actually a great idea, and it's always something that's like kind of bothered me about Audio Jungle. But in any case, I want to know what's selling on the site right now, not in like 2 years ago, right? So then I can make a really informed decision about what types of material I'm going to send them when I apply, right? So so in saying that, I made sure to send them less of my dark hybrid trailer tracks and more of my my upbeat, like, hip hop tunes, because I felt that would better suit the needs of the library just based on what I was hearing from them. So honestly, I really have nothing but great things to say about Motion Array from a creator's perspective. Fantastic communication with the staff right from the very start. I mean, they even have like a Slack channel where you can where contributors can ask questions to the staff like directly. So lots of accountability on their end, which is really nice to see, and it actually stands in stark contrast to some of the other libraries, which we all know. The review time is about a week or so usually, but that can fluctuate depending on how many submissions they're getting. And I would say that the uploading process is pretty straightforward. I mean, you have to add your own watermark to your track, which is kind of annoying, but it's not a big deal. Overall, I would say it's been a really pleasant experience to work with them. And I don't know, you just get the sense that it's a well-run operation with a creative team that actually cares about the direction and the curation of the material that they have on offer for their clientele. Recently, they were acquired by Artlist for a whopping $65 million. And while, of course, it's hard to say if and when or how this might affect the future of the library, I'd say it was a smart move on Artlist's part. And if anything, it's an indication of the level of value that Motion Array was bringing to the table. Since the acquisition, it's been business as usual. From my perspective, nothing's changed at all. And And my sales have been really great right from the start, which is something that I'm really, really grateful for, because, you know, it's been a real lifesaver as of late with, you know, the pandemic and all. I've lost all my gigging income for the year, and I've sort of managed to make up for some of those losses with the income that I'm making from Motion Array and the other libraries that I'm working with. So January is supposedly like a typically slow month for sales, but I'm currently hovering at a little over 800 USD, which is works out to over $1,000 Canadian, which is really, really great, you know. Previous months were comparable. I should mention that I'm only uploading about two or three tracks a month at this point. And I guess when I first started, I uploaded a chunk of my Audio Jungle back catalog. And then based on like what types of tracks were doing well, I slowed down my input with them, and then I spent more time with each submission. And this is actually something that I wanna talk about briefly as well. And I think that there's this like quantity over quality mindset that's pervasive within the stock music space. And I've definitely been guilty of this in the past. You know, and I do, of course, believe in maximizing efficiency and being able to, you know, complete tracks quickly and all that. But, you know, I've also been much more selective as of late about the tracks that I've been uploading. And this is just an effort to ensure that each of them do really well. And, I think it's a strategy that's really paying off for me. The last few songs that I've uploaded to Motion Array are consistently showing up as bestsellers on the site, usually coming within the first 30 or 20 or so most popular tracks of the month within the search results. And that's not me trying to brag. I think it's just a matter of, you know, simply strategizing a little bit more and spending a little extra time with my tracks, you know, making sure that the mixes are excellent, you know, making sure I've got all the alternative edits in place, etc. You know, and at this point, I'm not even uploading tracks that I'm not absolutely confident about and that like I'm stoked on. So I'd like to think that this reflects well on my reputation with the library. And, you know, hopefully they also get the sense that I'm being selective and meticulous. And, you know, I think it does go a long way because, well, recently they actually reached out to me and let me know that one of my tracks that I had uploaded was chosen as a staff pick, which means that I would get a little bit of extra promotion on the site, which is, you know, really, really nice. And it was a little bit of validation for me that they recognized the effort that I'm putting in. So all that being said, I'm in no position to criticize the subscription model. It seems to be working out pretty well for me. So far I would say that, you know, hats off to Motion Array for being a pleasure to work with. And I've been working with a few other libraries as of late, which has been really, really exciting. And I've got some big news to share with you guys on that front, but I think I'm gonna wait till it's all finalized and before I make any videos about that. So that's a discussion for another day. I know there's a lot of doubt and frustration out there amongst music producers about, you know, generating any kind of significant income from music licensing, but hopefully this video will serve as a bit of motivation for you. And you know, as you can see, it is definitely possible to make some money, and I think it's an exciting time to get into the business. You know, it is more competitive than ever, and it certainly is a crowded space, but I think that more than anything, it's really just a matter of, you know, finding your own unique voice and personality, you know, with your music and getting your productions up to, you know, the highest level possible, and just, you know, keep pushing harder, you know, get feedback from others in the community. And yeah, don't let your ego get in the way, you know, just be open-minded, be open to suggestions. You know, I can't tell you how important that was for my own personal development and growth. I really think that you need friends who are willing to give you the honest opinion, which can sting sometimes, but like, look, you know, if everyone's just telling you what you want to hear all the time, then you're never going to grow. I also think it's important to keep in mind that rejections aren't always a reflection on the quality of your music. It might just, you know, not be on brand for the library. And I'm certainly no stranger to rejections myself. If anything, I think they've been really helpful for me in the long run. I was actually recently just turned down by Melody Loops, and you know, hey, you know what? It's not a big deal. There's lots of other libraries out there, and plenty of opportunity to go around. Okay, that's enough from me. So as always, please don't hesitate to comment below. Let me know how you feel about subscription libraries. Let me know about how you feel about Motion Array or other libraries that you're working with. And as always, yeah, please don't hesitate to reach out anytime. I'm always happy to hear from you guys. And yeah, best of luck out there, and I will see you in the next video. Peace.